You know what, I decided to make another video in which I want to show you how powerful Asus ROG Ally is compared with Steam Deck. If in my previous video maybe you said, well, this and that, well, this is very simple. I have Red Dead Redemption 2, I will try it on each device, low settings here, low settings on Ally, and let's see the experience. So the game starts here in the wild with 50 frames on Steam Deck. First of all, let me show you the settings here. Let's go here to settings. As I said, I will have the same settings on each device. So, low settings, everything is here turned off, triple buffering, and so here I selected low preset. As you see, this is selected automatically only here on ambient occlusion on medium, and FSR is set to balanced mode, and also Vulkan API driver active. So, if in the wild you get on Steam Deck 40-50 frames with low settings, let's see what happens when we enter the town. So everything is beautiful at this point, but look here. frames, 39 frames, 36, 28, 29, and everything at 26 frames. And at this point, the game in any town, it's unplayable. So we have 20 frames here in the town. Look, I will do the same on Asus ROG Ally. And you will see what's happening. So we enter the main street, we get 27 frames, 26, 28. As you saw previously, the game dropped even to 25 frames, and this is a small town. So here you can only play with 27, 28 frames, which is, I would say, it's unplayable on low settings. This is not right. So 25 frames. So this is it. This is the power that we get for this game with FSR set to balanced mode. Imagine bigger locations with a lot of people. So here the average frame rate, it's 27 28. This is it. So let's turn off the game here and let's start it on ROG on Asus. Let's put it here, let's press play, and let's wait to start. First of all, let's write here the average frame rate in the game was something 27 28, basically this, not to mention the game had also 25 frames. So from 25 frames, and average was 27, 28 on Steam Deck. So let's see the game with the same settings here on Asus, and let's see what we will get in this way. And keep in mind that I will play only on battery, and you will say, what, you have turbo mode? Yes, you don't get a powerful device to play it on 10 watts. That's crazy, and it doesn't make any sense. You don't get, let's say, a powerful car to drive it with minimum consumption and so on, fuel and so on. You don't get in your house a light bulb to use it at 10%. That's insane. You get, if you get a light bulb in your house of 100 watts, and if you want 50 watts, buy a 50 watts bulb, but you won't get the same light. I hope you understand this analogy. Well, let's see the game here. I will try also turbo mode and performance mode to make an idea, but the idea is this. You get this device because you can play with 10 watts, 15 watts, your indie games, and so on. And when you want to go for a game like this one, you have the power that you need. So let's go here to settings and let's see the settings. So we have the graphics, we have low settings also here selected, the medium for ambient occlusion as on Steam Deck, and we have FSR set to balanced mode. Let's see the same game, let's see what it offers here. So now we have the real-time monitor, and let's see, we get 73 frames here. Let's wait to enter the town. Let's call here our transportation. Come here, friend. Not to mention the huge difference between displays. Starting with colors, starting with the refresh and response time. Look, we get 67 frames here. 67 frames. This is crazy. So we get here in town at this point 42 frames. Steam Deck got 28-25 frames. Whoa, this is insane. Look, 41 frames with a lot of action here. Let's do the same route as we did with Steam Deck. So basically this is it. Look, we get 43 frames at this point, 44, 45. This is what matters. Steam Deck got here 25 to 20, maximum 28 frames. Here you get over 40 frames. So this is the power that we talk about, and keep in mind that Steam Deck will offer you something between 40 and 60 depending on area. As you see here in the wild, we get 80 frames, so you'll be able to play in town with 40 frames, here in the wild with 60, 80 frames, as you saw from my previous gameplay. So this is the difference between these two devices. I don't want to make a very short video. So you get over 40 frames. Over 40 frames, and in the wild you got even 80 frames. So this is huge, and this is what I'm talking about. You really can play games like this one even with higher graphics on this device. Let's try to see if we are too far away of the of town. And I will try here. Unfortunately, we are. We have to reach again that town. I had that small accident. Okay. And I want to show you. I want to show you the game with performance mode. Let's see again the map here. I have to go like this. We will reach immediately the town. So here with turbo mode we get 80 frames. Let's see it with performance mode and let's see what happens. So with 20 watts we get 66 frames, which is pretty nice. Whoa. This is not good. Now turbo mode, instead of 15 frames, and here we have the town, let's see it. So we got our 40 frames as we had previously. Let's see it now with performance mode at 15 watts. So the same settings, but we have performance mode 15 watts here, 20 watts. And we get our 40 frames, 38 frames with 20 watts. So you can play with 20 watts, 19 watts, and you will get here in town 40 frames. This is insane. So why would you still prefer this device with 25, 28 frames when you can play with this one at 20 watts? That means almost 2 hours of gameplay. With 40 frames here in a town. So imagine you can even increase the quality and you can play with 30 frames for a handheld device. This is fantastic, especially if you increase the quality of the graphic. That's wow. So you see now that with 20 watts you get also 40 frames. You'd say, what about 10 watts? Well, if I change here to 10 watts, of course you cannot do anything with 10 watts. This is insane. Even if you want to play something like this, you have with 10 watts you get 16 frames. But why would you like to play a AAA game with like something like that? So back again at turbo mode, And as you see, you get 43 frames. What's wrong with you? 44 frames. Let's switch back to performance mode, 15 to 20 watts. And we have 42 frames with 19 watts. So again, you keep your 40 frames here, even if you play with 90 watts. So this is it. And I would say, unfortunately, this device cannot compete with Asus. It's a great device, it has a lot to offer, but unfortunately, it can't reach a performance like this one.